Kioko. Now, in the wake of increased public uproar, Energy Cabinet Secretary Charles Keter has directed the Energy Regulatory Commission to rationalize power tariffs to stave off inconsistencies. The announcement came even as Keter declared a possible reduction of power bills due to the ongoing rains. Francis Ontomo reports.
Nothing has generated as much controversy lately as the vexing discussion on power tariffs in Kenya. After postponing a meeting with a parliamentary committee last week, Energy Cabinet Secretary Charles Keter was leading his delegation to explain to Kenyans why power bills have taken an upward trajectory.
The metering system of KPLC over the past has been on estimation, and they were doing that for about 60%. They introduced the new system, was it July? Can you be specific? July, August. So you know, it's just by coincidence that the elections were in August, isn't it? So it has nothing to do with the election.
Even as Keter and his team set out to tell their side of the story, the meeting still shied away from explaining the annual report for the year ending June 2017 that opened the lid on the whopping 10.1 billion said to have been used on fuel. This is the amount the report said will be passed on to consumers.
Within the next 2 weeks, we will conclude what the agents are sorting out for us. And therefore, at that point, we will then get the aggregate number of customers that were affected and the total value of the transactions that they transacted.
Even aside from the sticky issues, there was some relieving announcement. The ongoing rains across the country, the ministry says, should lower down the cost of generating power.
For the whole of last year, the rainfall was a bit down. It pushed the FCC to almost 5 shillings and 35 cents. But right now with the rain, we will experience the cost of power coming down in terms of that one element of FCC.
Kenya's electricity supply structure is of single buyer model, with all generators selling in bulk to Kenya Power. What has remained firmly on the spotlight is the constitutional interpretation of this existence. The fourth schedule, paragraph 8E of the Constitution, offers that electricity and energy regulation is a county function and not national governments.
Even if we allowed another operator to come, to have to invest a duplicated system so that he can be able to sell electricity as an alternative to Kenya Power would be very costly.
Auditor General Edward Ouko has already kicked off investigations into the matter. Eyes remain firmly on the Energy Regulatory Commission on how they'll be beginning the process of harmonizing power tariffs here in the country. But even so, questions still abound on the inconsistencies that have been found both within the prepaid and the postpaid arrangements. Francis Ontomoa, KTN News, Nairobi.
Now the body of